Good afternoon to all. Today our class about valency and ions. From our 9th class 7th chapter, today we are discussing about valency and ions. This is the 5th lesson. Myself, B. Rajendra, school assistant, physical science, HBHS. Nothankal. What is the valency? Valency means combining capacity of an atom is known as its valency. We know that atoms and molecules, the number of atoms combined in chemical process and forms compounds and molecules. The number of atoms, how they are combined, the combining capacity only known as valency. What is the valency? How it is defined? We will be see. Here some valences are there. Valency means if a atom is loss or share the electron or gain the electron. Some atoms not sharing, not loss, not gain, stable as well as. So according to this, we will be consider the valency of the atom. Yes, hydrogen, if you take, the hydrogen element symbol is H. It will be loss one electron, so the valence is 1. Helium symbol is He. It neither loss nor gain the electron, not share, stable. So that's why not giving or not gaining, not taking, not giving. So 0. So the valence is 0. Lithium, Li, valence is 1. And it may be lost 1 electron. Beryllium, Be, it will be lost 2 electrons. So that's why valence is 2. How many electrons loss or gain by the atom or by the element, that number known as valency. That number of electrons only combining in the chemical bonding. So combining of electrons in chemical bonding, that number known as valency. In this way we can define. Boron, it will be lost 3 electrons, so valency 3. Carbon, sharing of 4 electrons, so valency 4. Nitrogen, gain 3 electrons, so valency is 3. Oxygen, gain means taking 2 electrons. Fluorine, gain 1 electron, so valence is 1. Sodium, it is loss, means giving, so the valence is 1. Magnesium, valence is 2. Aluminium, 3. Silicon, sharing of 4 electrons, so that's why valence is 4. Phosphorus, 3. Sulfur, 2. Chlorine, gaining the electron, means it is taking, so 1. Argon, it won't be sharing, means neither loss nor gain, so that's why valence is 0. Potassium, it will be giving, means loss 1 electron. Calcium, it will be loss 2 electrons, so valence is 2. Why I am saying loss and gain? There is a difference. Loss means it is giving to other element. Gain means it will be take electron from other element. For this variation, loss of electrons we will be indicated with a symbol, And gain of electrons also we indicated with another symbol. Valency may be same, but is it a gain or is it loss? For that clarification, we will be give some symbols. Here, valency means an electron on the outermost energy level in a atom. Which is the outermost electron? That electron will be loss, or in that outermost cell will be gain. So that's why the number of electrons in the outermost cell, that may be valency number to that element. Here sodium having 11 electrons. In the outermost cell, there is a only one electron. So it will be lost the electron. So the valency is one. Carbon having the outermost. Outermost means last one. The outermost, in the outermost cell, carbon having 4 electrons. So the valency is 4. Same like that. Valence electrons means outermost electrons. Here, the first fixture is carbon. It is having 4 electrons in green color. That are the valence electrons. Fluorine. Fluorine having 7 electrons in the outermost cell. So it will be gain. It will be gain, taking another one electron. So the arrow mark will be, seems to be gain. So one electron, it will be gain. So that's why fluorine have the valence as 1. Lithium. Lithium having only 1 electron in the outermost cell. It will be loss. Means it will be giving to that another element. So the valency is also for lithium 1. Fluorine will be take, lithium will be give. Means fluorine gain 1 electron, so valency 1. Lithium lost 1 electron, so that's why its valency also 1. Here the difference will be showing with that loss of electrons and gain of electrons in the symbol of plus and minus. For example, neutral item, atom. If the neutral atom lost an electron, the number of electrons will be right. If it is lost 1 electron, 1 you will be right as a valency, but it is loss. Loss means plus. In that next lesson, we will be clarify that why loss means why will you write plus. So plus 1. So the plus valency element known as cation. Loss of electron, we indicated with plus symbol. Gain of electron, we indicated with minus symbol. That is called as anion. On ion means gain of electron, indicated with minus symbol. Number of electrons, how many it will be gain, that number you should be right. For example, fluorine gain only 1 electron. So that's why that valency can write as minus 1. Sodium will be lost only 1 electron. So you can write as plus 1. Here you see that. Magnesium can lose 2 electrons. So the valence is 2. Loss of electrons, so 2 plus. Phosphorus can gain 3 electrons. That is anion, indicated with 3 minus. Magnesium cation, phosphorus anion. Aluminium will be lost 3 electrons. So it is the cation and write as 3 plus. Sulfur can take 2 electrons, gain 2 electrons, so indicated with the 2 minus. So sulfur valency is 2. Magnesium valency also 2. Phosphorus valency 3. Aluminium valency 3. But magnesium loss of electrons, so 2 plus. Sulfur gain of electrons, so 2 minus. Phosphorus gain of electrons, so minus 3 anion. Aluminium gain of 3 electrons, loss of 3 electrons, so plus 3 cation. In this way, we remember this. What is an ion? Compounds formed by metals and non-metals containing charged particles. Here plus and minus means plus charge, minus charge. Which is having plus charge, that is known as cation. Which is known as minus ion, minus charge means negative charge, that is known as anion. So compounds formed by metals and non-metals contain charged particles. The charged particles are known as ions. A negatively charged ion is called anion, means minus negative charged ion, anion. For example, phosphorus minus 3, sulfur minus 2, fluorine minus 1, chlorine minus 1, like that, which are gain the electrons. Electron having the negative charge. So that's why which is gain the electron means negative charge will be increased. So that's why it is indicated with negative sign and called as anion. Which element gain electrons that are having negative charge? So that's why it is indicated with negative symbol and called as anion. And some elements lost the electron. Lost the electron means some negativity decrease, means positive charge, protons charge increase, so plus. Which elements are lost electrons that are having the positive charge, that is positive ions, known as cations. For example, sodium plus 1, magnesium plus 2, calcium plus 2, aluminium plus 3, all metals can lose the electrons. So that's why that are all positive charges. Non-metals gain the electrons. So that's why they are having the negative charge, that are anions. For example, sodium chloride, that is the table salt, common salt. Manam general ga uppu antuntam. Sodium chloride is a common salt. So it is having sodium plus ion and chlorine minus ion. Sodium plus ion means it is positively charged. When it is positive charge occurs, loss of electron. So sodium lost one electron and get positive charge cation. The valence is plus one. The chlorine gain one electron. Gain one electron means having negative charge, means anion. So chlorine valence is minus one. Ions may be a charged independent atoms or a group of atoms that have a net charge on them. Hence, ions are charged particles. Here, number of examples are given, that OH having negative charge means it will be gain one electron. So OH minus. Minus, only minus symbol means it is gain only one electron, minus one. Simply we can write as minus. OH minus, NO3 minus, I minus, Cl, chlorine minus, bromine minus, I means iodine minus, F minus means fluorine minus, chlorine minus, hydrogen carbonate, HCO3 minus. If some elements will be gain two electrons, then it will be indicated with two minus. Sulfur gain two electrons. Sulfur is an anion. So S minus two, oxygen minus two, carbonate minus two, sulfate minus two, in this way. Some are gain three electrons. So these are also anions only. Phosphate minus three, nitrate minus three. We can classify the two ions in two types. One is cation, another one is anion. Cation means having the positive charge. Here, the T we can write as plus. For remember, cation, T ni manam plus lekka uhinchukunte. So T we will be remember as plus. So cation is the positive charge. We never be confused. Anion lo, first N ni manam negative ga tisukovali, negative charge kosam tisukovali. లేదా నెగటివ్ అయాన్లో టూ ఎన్స్ ఉన్నాయి కాబట్టి సో అయాన్ అయాన్ ఈస్ ద నెగటివ్ అయాన్ అని చెప్పి విల్ బి రిమెంబర్ దట్ వితౌట్ కన్ఫ్యూజన్ క్యాట్ అయాన్ అనగానే ప్లస్ పాజిటివ్ ఛార్జ్ లాస్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ అయాన్ అయాన్ అనగానే గెయిన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ నెగటివ్ ఛార్జ్ ఇన్ దిస్ వే కేటయాన్ మీన్స్ లాస్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ పాజిటివ్ ఛార్జ్ అయాన్ గెయిన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ నెగటివ్ ఛార్జ్ ఫ్రమ్ అవర్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ దెర్ ఈస్ ఏ టేబుల్ హీలియం ఆర్గాన్ నియాన్ క్రిప్టాన్ జీనాన్ దీస్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ఇన్ ద ఔటర్ మోస్ట్ సెల్ ఫుల్లీ ఫిల్డ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ దీస్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ నైదర్ గివ్ మీన్స్ లాస్ నైదర్ గెయిన్ మీన్స్ టేకింగ్ సో హీలియం ఆర్గాన్ హీలియం నియాన్ ఆర్గాన్ క్రిప్టాన్ జీనాన్ దిస్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ద వ్యాలెన్స్ యాజ్ జీరో సో హియర్ ఓన్లీ వన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఈస్ గివెన్ హీలియం బ్యాలెన్స్ ఈస్ జీరో మీన్స్ నైదర్ లాస్ నార్ గెయిన్ ద ఎలక్ట్రాన్ హైడ్రోజన్ బ్యాలెన్స్ వన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గెయిన్ ద వన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఫ్లోరిన్ బ్యాలెన్స్ వన్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ గెయిన్ ద వన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ క్లోరిన్ వన్ ఆక్సిజన్ టూ మీన్స్ ఇట్ విల్ బి టేకింగ్ టూ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ నైట్రోజన్ త్రీ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ సో బ్యాలెన్స్ ఈస్ త్రీ కార్బన్ విల్ బి టేక్ ఫోర్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ సో ద బ్యాలెన్స్ ఈస్ ఫోర్ ద కెపాసిటీ ఆఫ్ షేరింగ్ ద ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఎయిదర్ లాస్ ఆర్ గెయిన్ ద నెంబర్ నోన్ యాజ్ వ్యాలెన్సీ ఆఫ్ ద గివెన్ ఎలిమెంట్ బట్ వీ క్లాసిఫై దట్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ షేరింగ్ ద ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఇట్ విల్ బి టేకింగ్ మీన్స్ గెయినింగ్ ఆర్ లాసింగ్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గెయినింగ్ దట్ ఈస్ నెగటివ్ ఛార్జ్ దట్ ఈస్ ఆనయాన్ సింబల్ విత్ మైనస్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ లాస్ దట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ పాజిటివ్ ఛార్జ్ మీన్స్ కేటయాన్ the symbol with positive. Here the table given in our textbook, hydrogen H plus. Sometimes hydrogen can give the electron, means in lost the electron. So sometimes it is the plus ion. Sometimes it will be most times it will be take the electron, gain the electron. So H minus. Means hydrogen having the capacity of the loss of electron. If it is loss, then it will becomes as a cation and H plus 1. The valence is plus 1. If the hydrogen gain the electron, then it will be having the negative charge. That means ion minus 1. Sodium, Na plus, means cation, loss 1 electron. Potassium, K plus. Silver, Ag plus. Copper, Cu plus. Ammonium, NH4 plus. One unit means which element can lose one electron that are all having the plus one ion charge that is cation. If it is lost two electrons, then it is having two units of the charge. Magnesium can lose two electrons, so Mg plus two. Calcium, Ca plus two. Zinc, Zn plus two. Copper, Cu plus two. Iron, Fe plus two. If it is last three electrons, then aluminium, Al plus 3, iron, Fe plus 3. These are all losing the electrons. So these are all cations. These are all having positive charge. These are all indicated with plus symbol. If some elements are gain the electrons, then we will be called as anions indicated with negative sign. So hydride means hydrogen can gain one electron H minus. Only one means H minus, you can write. If you write like this also, minus one, H minus one. Chlorine, Cl minus one. Bromide, Br minus one. Iodide, I minus. Fluoride, F minus. Hydroxide, OH minus. Means these are all gain the one electron. Nitrate, up to nitrate, minus one only unit. Oxide, two electrons gain, so indicated with minus two. Sulfide, S minus two. Sulfate, SO4 minus two. Carbonate, CO3 minus two. Dichromate, minus two. Some are gain the three electrons. Nitrate, minus 3, phosphate, PO4 minus 3. These are all gain the electrons. So having negative charge. So called as anions. Symbol is minus. In this way, we can classify the valency. You can write the valency. And that valency also positive or negative. Cation or anion. According to the loss of electrons and gain. Here, hydrogen valency is 1. It may be lost the electron, gain the electron. So sometimes plus 1, sometimes minus 1. Helium, neither give nor gain. And neither loss nor gain. So this valence is 0. Nitrogen, valence is 3. Always it takes or gain 3 electrons. So N minus 3. Cl, valence is 1. Always it gain only 1 electron. So anion, Cl minus 1. Oxygen. All anions, I wrote it a place. So valency of oxygen minus 2. Carbon minus 4. Here, another one, magnesium. It will lost the 2 electrons. So magnesium plus 2, cation. Aluminium, lost the 3 electrons. So aluminium plus 3, cation. Sodium, lost 1 electron, cation plus 1. Fe can give 2 electrons sometimes, can give 3 electrons sometimes. Means it will be lost 2 electrons and also 3 electrons. So the cation of the ferrum, iron, the valence will be 2 and 3. Valency of an ion is equal to the magnitude of its charge. For example, valence of chloride ion Cl minus, you can write as 1. How much of the charge, that much of the number only we can write as valence. Means how many the number of electrons it will be lost, that is the valency of that given element. So that's why valency is always equivalent to that ion's magnitude. Means loss of 2 electrons means minus 2. Loss of 2 electrons means plus 2. Gain of 2 electrons means minus 2. So sulfate gain 2 electrons. So we can write as minus 2. So the valency also 2. Magnitude is same. And after that, another topic is atomic mass. We are understanding about that atoms. Atom is also a part of the matter. Matter consists of the atoms. If you weigh the matter, it is having some mass. Matter having the mass means that parts also having the mass. Means individual part of the matter is that atom. We know that in the first lesson. So matter having the mass means atom also. Remarkable concept that Dalton's atomic theory proposed was atomic mass. Atomic mass, according to him, each element had a character. One atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit indicated with AMU. Atomic A mass M unit U is defined as the mass exactly 1/12 the atomic mass of carbon 12 isotope. The number of times of one atom of given element is heavier than 1/12 of the atomic mass of carbon is called atomic mass. First, they are taking as a standard weight of the carbon 12 isotope. Carbon 12. Manaki carbon anatomy element telsu kada, dani yokka atomic mass 12. దాంట్లో 6 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఉంటాయి, 6 ప్రోటాన్స్ ఉంటాయి. సో ఆటమిక్ మాస్ 12. ఆ 12ని 12th పార్ట్ చేస్తే ఒక్కొక్క పార్ట్ ఒక్కొక్క ఆటమిక్ యూనిట్కి ఈక్వలెంట్. ఏ ఎలిమెంట్నైనా మనం కంపేర్ చేసినప్పుడు ఆ 1/12 కంటే ఎన్ని టైమ్స్ హెవియర్గా ఉందో అది దాని యొక్క ఆటమిక్ మాస్గా చెప్పడం జరుగుతుంది. సో నౌ ద ఆటమిక్ మాస్ ఈస్ డిఫైన్డ్ on the basis of carbon 12 isotope's mass, they will be take 1/12 of the part of atomic mass of carbon 12 as a one atomic mass unit. If you take any element, that is how many times heavier than 1/12 of the atomic mass of the carbon, that is known as atomic mass. For example, if you take a hydrogen, hydrogen atomic mass unit is 1. So atomic mass is 1. Means 1/12 of the carbon isotope mass is equivalent to 1 hydrogen mass. So 1/12 part is known as 1 atomic mass unit. So the hydrogen atomic mass is 1. For example, if you take oxygen, oxygen atomic mass is 16. Means it is the 16 times of the 1/12 of the atomic mass of carbon. So oxygen atomic mass is 16. In this way, they will be explained. Atomic mass of an element is a ratio, hence it has no units, but it is expressed in AM according to the latest IUPAC names. The symbols are all given by the IUPAC names. The atomic mass definition here given. If, for example, carbon having 6 protons, neutrons having 6 protons, 6 neutrons. So atomic mass is 6 plus 6 is equal to 12. This atomic mass of carbon 12 will be divided into 12th part. That one part known as atomic mass unit. Here some atomic mass units are given. Hydrogen, if you compare the hydrogen mass with 1/12 of the 1/12 part of the carbon, it is only one time. So 1 × 1/12, that is one atomic mass unit. So hydrogen atomic mass is 1. Carbon, 12 parts. So 12 times, 12 × 1/12. 12 cancel means it will be having 12 atomic mass units. Nitrogen, 14 times to that 1/12 part of the carbon. So the atomic mass of the nitrogen is 14. Oxygen, 16. Sodium, 23 times. So that atomic mass is 23. Magnesium, 24. Aluminium, 27. Phosphorus, 31. Sulfur, 32. Chlorine, it is 35.5 times of 1/12 of the carbon isotope. So that's why the chlorine atomic mass is 35.5 atomic units. Potassium, 39. Calcium, 40. In this way, they have calculated. In our textbook, do you know, two questions are given here. Atomic weights of elements were determined in the beginning with reference to hydrogen by John Dalton. First of all, they will compare with that hydrogen molecule, but it is not proper. After that, they are taking oxygen, 1/16th part of the oxygen, but it is also difficult to compare all elements. So finally, they are taking carbon 12 isotope atomic mass unit. That 12 atomic mass weighs divided into 12 parts. 1/12 of the atomic mass of a carbon isotope is equivalent to one atomic mass unit. In this way, they clarify by the IUPAC. So in this way, they are calculating all elements atomic mass compared with the 1/12 part of the carbon 12 isotope mass. This is our lesson today. Thank you. Thank you to all.